album did you spend the longest time recording?
Either Come and Get It or Love Will Remember.
Yeah. How long would you say you spent?
Come and Get It and actually Love Will Remember were about 3 to 4 days.
Wow.
So, yeah.
So you just don't go in and be singing, I'm done.
No, especially with, you know, those two tracks, I wanted to put in everything I could from production and adding things from melody changes and harmonies. We spent a lot of time on those.
Okay. Do you consider yourself like a perfectionist where you'll go in and tweak the littlest thing because it's you know, it has to be perfect?
Yes, kind of. But I actually like to learn from all the producers that I work with because I sometimes don't catch the things that they catch because I get too excited. And I'm like, perfect, let's release it. And they're like, well, calm down. Let's kind of fix it. So they actually have taught me things as well. But I do like to make sure the record is as perfect as it can be.
No, because I know a lot of artists that I've talked to, they'll say, I think it's perfect, then I put it out, and then I'll hear it, and then I'll go, oh, why didn't I change this? Does that ever happen?
Yeah, that's happened a couple of times, yeah? For sure, yeah.
Now, when you perform it, do you switch it up to the way you wanted it?
Yeah, kind of, especially for the tour. We're doing a lot of fun remixes of the old songs that I've done. I can't wait for everyone to hear them because they're so cool. We threw in, like, some dubstep in one of the tracks. It was fun.
So cool. All right, so in the On Lights from Twitter, they want to know, what's your dream collaboration?
Probably Jason Mraz, so I could just stare at him.
Yeah.
I think that'd be nice, just so he could sing to me.
He is good looking.
I think he's super cute, and I love his music.
So. I want to collaborate with David Beckham, but I can't say how.
I don't know, maybe in line for Adidas. Yeah, you could be the model on him.
Exactly, that would be very nice.
I find my ways.
Sun Shall Shine wants to know, if you would want to, would you encourage your sister, your new baby sister, to have the same job as you, if that's what she wanted to do?
If that's what she wanted to do, but I definitely wouldn't encourage it. I just would want her to do her path and her own thing.
Okay. So. Maybe one day you guys will sing together.
I know. I already sing to her now, and I miss her. So, but she's so cute. She's perfect.
You're saying that that's like one of the things that you get most excited about when you get home, and there she is.
I know. I don't even say hi to my parents. I just go straight to her.
That's so cool.
Like straight
now,
there.
You still live at home.
I do, yes.
Okay. Now, 21, do you think like, well, now I have to move out?
I don't think I have to, but I'm about to leave for a really long tour, so I don't think it's a big deal right now, but I think it might be time for me to leave.
So. Does mom still tell you what to do?
No, she's great. Yeah? I mean, if I eat all of her food, she gets mad because she says I could go buy my own food, but I do steal her food.
You don't have a curfew, though, do you?
No, I don't.
Okay. Well, because you never know.
Yeah, of course, but I get it, yeah.
I'm trying, you know, I have two little ones. I have to try and figure out how I'm going to do this.
Right. Yes.
It's not
tricky.
Easy.
It isn't.
Irish Selenator wants to know, what makes you better when you're... I know. I hope I'm pronouncing these Twitter handles.
Selenator.
Oh, my God.
It's okay. I just know.
Okay, there you go.
That's so cute, though.
You know all your peeps.
I do know my peeps.
What makes you better when you're feeling sad? Now, I know we said you're a little sister, but
yes,
what
else? Absolutely. I think my friends always make me happy. They know how to take any situation or any problem I'm having and just turn it upside down instantly.
That's why it's very good to keep like positive people you grew up with around you, because they keep, one, they keep you grounded, I think, and two, they're the real deal.
Absolutely, you know? I agree.
Yeah. I love it. Irma Nieto from Facebook says, okay, the weirdest thing you've ever autographed. A bum. Did you autograph a butt?
Not yet. Not yet. Like toilet paper.
Really?
Yeah. I don't know why.
Yeah.
I think Band-Aids.
Okay.
Yeah. Used ones.
What? And you touched them?
I sign them. They're for my fans. I'm just like, okay.
Most of the guys say, a boob. I autographed a boob.
A poop. Have not had one of those either yet, but...
And one of the bloggers, Swagger New York, says, you're here. Okay. So, see, I got your name right at least. There you go. Stars Dance is an absolute turn-up record.
Turn-up.
What is the one track that people are going to go bananas for in the club, and now that you're 21, you can join in on the fun?
Probably Beat. I think Beat is really fun, especially on tour. We the dancers have killed that dance routine, and that's the one I'm most exhausted in. So,
cool.
It's so much fun.
You don't have to do you have to watch what you eat while you're on tour, or because you're doing so much dancing, you can eat, you know, cheeseburgers?
I probably should, but I don't. I love food too much to watch what I mean, I can't have like a salad. I need food.
Salad is like the beforehand to the food.
I can't get there. I go straight for the food.
Oh, yeah, yeah. What's like the one thing you really love to eat, like if you're going to be really bad?
That's like every day. I just had spaghetti this morning and chicken tenders. I usually love anything with carbs, like pizza or, you know, I don't know, bread.
How about sweets?
A lot of sweets, yes. Yeah. Chocolate. Love Reese's.
That's me. Oh, my
Reese's
gosh.
Are so good.
Peanut butter and chocolate.
I'm kind of hungry now, so. But.
All right, now before I let you go, I heard that you got a new car recently.
I did.
And I was reading in People magazine that you had to text your mom and say you were sorry because you hit something with the car in the driveway.
Yeah, I hit our trash cans and our gate. I've hit two things. It's difficult. I've had the same car since I was 16, so I decided, I'm going to be a grown-up this year and get a new car, and I've had to have the paparazzi help me back it up. I've hit things. Oh. I don't even... It's just like, I just try to be an adult and then just mess it all up, but it was fun, and I like it. I'm getting used to it now. I'm getting better, and as long as I have not hit any cars or anything else, I'm fine.
That's very good. And so the paparazzi, I know they're sometimes right in your face and everything, but at least it seems like they're helpful at times.
Yeah, I mean, I don't really necessarily like to communicate with them, but I just was stuck. So I just said, will you do it? I was by myself,
right.
And there were all of them. So just, will you help me?
If you're in that situation.
Yeah, might as well.
All right, now you always look so fantastic.
Thank you.
We know you have a great makeup artist because we've met her before. Actually, whatever lipstick you had on, I bought it the last time I saw you.
Good.
Doesn't look as good on me, but that's okay. But do you have any, like, beauty routines that you do? I mean, I know we'd all want to know, like, the girly questions. Like, do you at night, like, wash your face with a certain wash and a certain moisturizer?
Yeah, I think it's important to do that. I wear so much makeup for my job, so when I'm home, I wear zero makeup, and I just kind of wash it every night and every morning. So pretty simple.
Yeah.
I'm not too fancy.
Not fancy? When you get older, you're going to have to be fancy. Just wait.
I'm going to live it up till then.
Oh, my goodness. All right, so are you guys ready to hear Selena perform? All right, we're going to give her a little bit of a break. We're going to let her relax for 5 minutes,
seconds.
And then we're going to bring her back on. But
awesome.
Selena, thank you so
thank
much.
You.
Thank
I'm
you.
I'm excited to come out. Thanks, guys.
Selena Gomez! All right, we'll be right back.